Oh God, be with those bygone days when youthful light did roam down by Glencullen's flowery graves beside your native home, with mountains, dells, and fields of green and moorlands broad and wide. That rank woodlake that can be seen down by Glencullen's side, the graceful crest of Dublin Hill are my last sights to see. Then farther on and darker still lies lonely Lochnagie, where in the days that's now long gone there started a landslide that brought destruction on its way down by Glencullen's side. Then further north the schoolhouse stands beside the public road, with fertile fields on either side, quite near to my abode, where often in my youthful days I played at evening tide, with comrades grand who had to be down by Glencullen's side. They had to leave their native home and cross the raging sea and settle on a foreign land their future homes to be. The pretty girls so fair and blonde, both modest and blue-eyed, are exiles on a foreign land, far from Glencullen's side. Alas, I fear those days are gone, we ne'er shall see no more, when free from care we sported on the lake of Cardamore. Alas, from home we had to go across the raging tide and bid you to
1, 2, 3.
Other night, dear, as I lay sleeping, I dreamed I held you in my arms. When I awoke, dear, I was mistaken, so I bowed my head and I cried. You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are gray. You'll never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away. And made you happy, and nothing else could come between. But now you've left me to love another. You have shattered all of my dreams. You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are gray. You'll never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away.
Chinese doctor, you know, like one of these love portion. So he went, and the Chinese doctor said, I hope you're not taking my picture.
No, I'm not. I'm looking on Facebook.
The Chinese doctor said, I give you a portion. You go home, you come back, and you tell me how everything is.
Yeah.
So can it to your face. He's over there. Yeah, you tell me how everything went. Come back in a week. So he came back in a week. Dr. Nolo, I give you another portion. You come back in a week. Give you another portion. He came back in a week, and Nolo was the baby. So then he said, go in my office. Take your clothes off. Now go down on your knee, hands and knees. You can leave your shoes on. Now, crawl to the, over there to the wall. He said, crawl over to the wall. And now back up to me. And he said, let me see your face. He looked at his face. Then he said, you got exactly disease. He said, what? He said, you got exactly disease. So he said, what is that? He said, your face looks exactly like your ass. That was his problem solved.
And you can keep your shoes on.
And you can keep your shoes on. She added that herself.
That's a good joke, because it keeps people's attention.
Mm-hmm. Mm, exactly.